All right, so to give you a little story before the story, I was editing a 300th video. Quite epic 300th video, if I do say so myself. It was a Minecraft montage of all the funniest moments of all my Minecraft videos. I had over 7 hours worth of video, and then I trimmed that down to like 20 minutes. And I was quite satisfied with what I had done. There was like over 100 and something clips in it, and it was crazy stuff. And so I go to render it, and the files failed. You want to know why they failed? Because Windows Live Movie Maker is an untrustworthy program. I don't want to go on about this too much, but I'm going to say this next part as well, because I am absolutely fed up with this program, and I advise that if you want to be creative or intuitive at all, please do not use Windows Live Movie Maker, because it will just get your hopes up and then crush them. So, yeah, anyway, so after this, you know, 14 hours worth of my life was wasted because, you know, trimming good clips and stuff and editing y'all, that takes a long time, out of 7 hours. So yeah, I figured, you know what, man, I can't let this kill me. So what do? I edit together a 1 hour plus, well, 1 hour and 15 minute long NSQ, and it was great. I edited it so thoroughly, and there was like lots of, you know, it was really good. It was a good episode. And for some reason, again, I guess the video is just too long. The program will not render the video, no matter what I do. And I am usually able to solve these problems, but I can't. So the real question I have for the people who have created, you know, Windows Live Movie Maker: why is it that you allow me to edit the video but not to render it? It's just cruel. It's not nice, and it really, really is a. It is beyond frustrating. I'm trying my hardest to be happy before this this story, but I guess without further ado, let's get into the story. Welcome back, everyone, and say hello to the 300th video celebration. Now, it's not the epic video that you were all expecting, considering it took me 3 weeks, but, well, I think that my my future self will let you know why that isn't the case. Hopefully you've already been informed. Yeah, so, to get off of the depressing parts, let's get into the story. 300th video, big milestone, good stuff, we've made it a long way. Hallelujah, let's go. Alright, so, at the start of grade 4, you know, I was all excited, new teacher, new everything. You go from the, the primary grades to the senior grades, junior to senior is what they called it. Like, grade 1 to 3 was junior, and then grade 4 to 5 was senior. So, man, we were officially seniors, like, we were all excited, it was great, we're big boys now. So, you know, first day, we have a new teacher, and this teacher, let's just call her Miss Pineapple, because, you know, she's prickly, and when you cut her open, she looks like she'll be sweet, but she's sour. So, Miss Pineapple, she was old, she was an old lady, alright, so she was probably, if I had to guess, between 70 and 80, maybe even higher, I don't know. And she was a very stale, very, very boring sounding person, you know, not enthusiastic at all, and a little bit depressing, a little bit. And so, Mrs. Pineapple, well, the first day, she basically gave us the ground rules, and immediately I was like, wow, man, this is a bit harsh, like, is this what it's like to be a senior? Because the first day, she basically explained to us that at the start of each day, whatever homework we had the previous day, we had to show her right at the start, okay? That way we did not have a chance to weasel out and, like, do it during lunch or something. She wanted us to do our homework at home, okay? She wanted to make sure, right? So, basically, each day, you know, she would check the homework right at the start. Like, we wouldn't even be doing math, and she would check math first. Okay, just to make sure, because she doesn't want us to copy her friends, I guess, or whatever. Anyway, and so if you didn't do your homework, she would mark your name on a chart, right, of the people who didn't do their homework. And of course, that would result in, you know, getting either a good or a satisfactory on your report card for homework completion. And, you know, a lot of kids didn't really care about that because their parents didn't care about that. My parents cared about that. So it was, you know, it's something that bothered me if I were to, you know, potentially get my name on that list. So, you know, the first month it all went good, you know. Math I picked up pretty easily back then. It was a bit simple. And I, you know, I did it every night, all my homework, all that stuff. Anyway, and I was playing soccer at the time. That's when that is when I first got into competitive soccer. So I had soccer every night. Maybe not every night, but most nights. So yeah, there was this one night where, you know, we got an exceptionally large amount of homework, and I, you know, decided to do my English first, which was writing in a journal, and then I, you know, started working on my math, but then I had to go to soccer, and soccer was, you know, 7 to 9, and, you know, I mean, when I got back home, it's freaking 9 o'clock. My bedtime was 9 o'clock, and I was just thinking, like, man, do I really want to torture myself with this homework? You know what? I'll wake up early, and I'll do the homework, and it'll all be good. And so, strange turn of events, I actually woke up early, and everything was good. So I woke up, and I was doing my homework, and it was all good. And, you know, I made good headway, and I was kind of close to being done, but I still had, like, you know, 3 or 4 questions. So I tell myself, you know, I'm just going to do it on the bus, and maybe even some of my friends will help me, you know, maybe, you never know. So I go on the bus, and I start doing my homework, and slowly my friends get on the bus, because, you know, I'm the first one on the bus, swag demon. And what happened was, I ended up going, like, none of my friends on the bus had done their homework. I only had 2 friends on the bus who were in my class, because this is how it worked. My class was a grade 4-5 split, and then there was a separate grade 4 class. So I was in grade 4, right? So in my class, there was half grade 4s, half grade 5s, and then there was another grade 4 class that was all grade 4s. So I was separated from my grade 4 pals, most of them, all right? So there was only a select few amount of my good friends that were in my class. So most of my good friends were in this class with a teacher called Mrs. Orange, because, you know, I guess she was pretty sweet. So they barely got homework, and they were, like, laughing at me because I had homework. And I'm just like, wow, this kind of sucks. You guys aren't helping me at all. And the, you know, the 1 or 2 guys who actually were in my class with Miss Pineapple, they didn't do their homework because, you know, I mean, they're stupid. And so I ended up getting stuck on a question, and I was a perfectionist, right? So I wouldn't just pretend to have done it. I needed to figure it out, and the answers weren't in the back of the textbook back then, or at least I didn't check. And so I ended up having to finish it in the schoolyard, because, you know, you get like 2 minutes or 3 minutes before you actually get to go inside of the school. So I was doing it against the wall of the schoolyard. And I just about finished when my friend Matt, okay, came and he asked me what I was doing. And I was like, I'm doing the math homework. Now, my friend Matt, okay, he's a good guy. I like Matt, you know. He's the one who introduced me to Xbox in, like, grade 6. So, I mean, hats off to you, Matt, but, like, go kill yourself. Because he's a grade higher than me. So, you know, grade 4-5 split class, right? So I'm grade 4, he's grade 5. But we're in the same class. So he understands the struggle of Miss Pineapple. And for some reason, I cannot kind of understand this because my brother does this. But he was in the mood to piss me off, I guess. So he starts, like, joking, like, man, I'm going to tell Miss Kit that you were doing it in the yard. Oh, man, you didn't finish your homework at home. Oh, man, I'm going to tell on you. And I was like, dude, screw off, man. Come on. I'm just about to finish. Anyway, so I finish. And then the bell rings almost immediately. And he grabs it out of my hand. I'm like, what? He grabs it out of my hand and runs into the school, into our class, and just starts yelling, Miss Pineapple, Miss Pineapple, he didn't do his homework, Miss Pineapple. And I'm just like, what are you doing? Are you, what, why? Why, Matt? Oh my God. Why'd you do this to me? And I was just like, so livid, man. It was not even funny. My God, and I felt pretty pathetic, too, because I was, like, chasing after him, trying to grab it, and I knew I was good. God damn, it sucked, man. And so, basically, like, if you think about it, she shouldn't even punish me, right? Like, my homework's done. Like my homework is done, and it wasn't done in school, and it's finished. So, I mean, I shouldn't get punished, right? But the way Matt was saying it, I guess it sounded like he was accusing me, obviously, and so... Anyway, so she sees it, whatever. She sees that because I was writing it on the bus and on, against the wall, you know, some of the last few questions are, you know, my handwriting's a little bit messed up, but I'm going to say this right now, my handwriting, even back then, it was solid. I had good handwriting, okay, and I still do. Like, people think that my handwriting is a girl's sometimes because of how awesome it is, so, I mean, my handwriting should have still been acceptable. Anyway, so she has no real proof of anything, but I guess, here's the thing, she sees it and she's like, is this true? Did you really do it in the yard or whatever? And I'm like, I don't want to lie to her, right? Because there was witnesses, man. Like, I don't want to risk that. But I don't know what the consequences are if you lie to Miss Pineapple. So, I was like, well, yeah. And so I figured to myself, like, you know, I still did my homework. And here's what she does, right? She takes the list of who did their homework. She goes over to me, X's my name right in front of me, man, right in front of me, like as if I had just done something terrible. And I had made so many death threats behind her back that day. It was not even funny. I literally said to her when she crossed my name off, I said to her, it's still done. It's right here. Like, I finished it at home, most of it. And it's not, I didn't finish in your class. I didn't copy anybody. I still understand the math. I comprehend it better than half the other class, goddammit. So, I mean, I didn't say most of that, but I said that I had still done it at home. You know what I mean? Like, I was pissed off. Little things like that bothered me a lot more than it should have, I guess. But that right there, that sealed her fate, man. That made our relationship a very complicated one from that point on. There's one thing I will say. It's that after that, I did all my homework at home, and I forced myself, and I stayed up late. So I guess it was kind of a good lesson. But at the same time, you bitch, man. Like, why'd you do that? And Matt, this is, you know, for all the good things you've done with me, Matt, there's been a lot of things you've screwed me over with. Like, that was not the last time you screwed me over, Matt. In a future story, I might reveal that time. And you know what time I'm talking about, man. Goddamn know it. Anyway, so, that right there, that pretty much set the mood for me and Miss Pineapple. It was just, I didn't like her, basically, from that point. And so, of course, I kind of went on a bad streak with her. So there was also weekly homework where we had to, like, fill in a journal. And it could be either, you know, talking about your day or talking about your weekend or writing a fictional story, things like that. And so, you know, I did all that normally, and she would always mark me off, like, she would always take off marks for the weirdest things, like, you know, I would put too many spaces in between words, she thought I would be, like, trying to shyster myself out of doing a full page, but, I mean, and then she would dock me marks because my freaking lettering was too big, like, come on, miss, some other kids can't even spell the word to, or the, like, I'm advanced. So, you know, I felt like she was being a little bit strange towards me. Anyway, and then this was kind of something stupid on my part, but she made us create a fictional story, and I had created the stupidest fictional story I could possibly conjure up. It just had to do with video games, and I think I might have sworn that, or I used the word poo or crap or something like that, and she docked me marks. I got very low marks for that story, right? So it was clear to her that I was a bit of a rebellious young one, you know, creating strange stories when she knows that she won't like them. And so every day I would just walk into class, and man, I'd just be dreading the day. Like, I'd just be like, oh God, what are we going to get now? God damn. And this was the first time that I've ever genuinely hated a teacher. And I was not the only one. A lot of people disliked her, like, genuinely. And so, I guess just one day we had a supply teacher after, like, 2 months, the first supply teacher of the year, and we were like, yeah, America, we got a supply teacher. And his name is Dr. C, and man, Dr. C is so cute, man. Like, I still have him today. Like, I don't know how, but he keeps on following me. Like, this was elementary school, right? And now he teaches as a supply in high school for me. Like, I don't know how, but he's a follower. He's just everywhere. So yeah, Dr. C, he's about, you know, maybe 4'2", something like that. Like, I think I was taller than him back then, right? So, I mean, this guy's short, and, you know, he's a good guy, great guy. And, you know, I don't know about a teacher, but I've only ever seen him supply teach, so I don't know if he's a good teacher. But this day, he was supplying for Miss Pineapple, and, you know, we had to create a fictional story with partners, okay? And so, me and my friend Jack, we decided to collaborate, and originally, it was going to be, you know, something serious. But then I showed Jack my previous work of it involved like Mario and some stupidity. And so we just thought to ourselves, like, you know what, man, we're just gonna make something so stupid. And the story that we created, I think it was like the basic premise of it. I still have the book with all these things. I think I have the book, okay? And maybe I'll show the story in future. But for now, the title of the story, it was something to do with, like, it was Mario, Peach, and Donkey Kong, you know, the Mario characters. It was something like that. Goes to the supermarket. So I think it was Donkey Kong goes to the supermarket or something. And so they all go to the supermarket, basically, and then it ends with, like, Donkey Kong eating poo. And it was just all about poo. We had the word poo in there, like, 17 times. And that was a lot back then, because the story was only, like, 2 pages. So, and then, to be even more stupid, me and Jack, like, pretty much volunteered and, like, begged to present it to the class, right? And so Dr. C, he lets us eventually, and me and Jack, we go up there, we try reading the story, and we just kept on laughing, like, every sentence. Like, it was impossible for us to read, and we just could not stop laughing. And the class, every time we said poo, was like, ha ha ha! Poo is so funny. That's a funny word, huh? And Dr. C, he was just like, he just let us go, man. Like, at that point, I guess he needed a little bit of entertainment too, and he found it through these stupid little boys. And yeah, so he was pretty cool about it. But I wasn't sure. I thought to myself, like, man, Dr. C, he might rat us out. Like, Miss K, I mean, she might find out. And then we remembered, like, oh, dude. Oh, shoot. Oh, man, Miss K's gonna be marking this. Oh, God. Oh, no. Oh, man. So we're like dreading the day, and of course we're not gonna rewrite it, cause screw that jazz. Jack is still in freaking competitive hockey, so I mean, you know, he's still consumed with his time in hockey, and at the time I had soccer, and so we were like, okay, we're not gonna rewrite it. So I mean, we were ready to roll with the punches, and so we go the next day, and there's a new supply. And we're like, what? Another supply teacher? Whoa! And this supply, we'll call her Miss Sunshine, because she was so, I don't know, so warm and bright. And so Miss Sunshine, man, Miss Sunshine was like nice, like really nice, like too nice. Like, it was like weird nice. It was like Christian Bible camp nice. And she was like a young teacher, like this was her like first time supplying or whatever, and it was like awesome, and we were like, whoa. And she like let us do our math home, like, and she, man, she like said she would like write a note to Mrs. Pineapple saying how she won't assign the homework or whatever, and we were like, wow, man, what world do you come from? Oh my God. And so, and that was a great day and all, but we realized, of course, Miss Pineapple would be coming back. So we come back the next day, and Mrs. Sunshine's there again. And again the next day, and the next day, and the next day. For a full week, we have Miss Sunshine, until eventually the principal comes into our classroom at the start of the day and says, guys, due to some unfortunate circumstances, Miss Pineapple will not be able to teach at the school anymore. And then when I hear this, man, like, I'm just like, is this for real? Like, are you really? Like, are you serious? Is this for real? Yes! Oh my God! Yes! Yes! Yeah! Oh, I can't believe it! I'm so lucky! So does that mean that we keep Miss Sunshine? And then I didn't actually ask if we keep Miss Sunshine, but she never went away. So I mean, and I think she's still at that school, and I mean, hell, man. The only flaw to Miss Sunshine was that she was too nice. Like, we couldn't do violent, like, any form of violence. Like, we couldn't play dodgeball, okay? And I'm telling you right now, our school was a bit of a ghetto, you know, school. And we could only afford dodgeballs. So we would be going into the gym and, like, be playing safe catch, which is, like, when you just walk up to somebody and place the ball in their hand. It's like, oh, man, you got it. Good job. And so... So yeah, I mean, I would still take Miss Sunshine is any day. Like I meant to save this for another story, but like she saved me from getting in trouble at one point when I really deserved to. So I guess Miss Sunshine, you know, I like Miss Sunshine. I guess it's a love hate relationship, but it's better than Mrs. Pineapple. So at the time, it didn't register to me, Mrs. Pineapple. You know, like, when she's that old and unfortunate circumstances, I didn't even question what had happened to her. Now, when you think back, if you ask me, I think she died. I'm not gonna lie. That or someone she was very close to died. She could have gotten cancer. Like, it's kind of depressing. I mean, I don't... It's funny, because I probably did wish that those things to happen to her, but, like, I didn't want it to happen. I mean, that's kind of bad that I kind of wish that into it. Like, that's not good. I mean, if, like, you know, I've wished my brothers to be dead, but I wouldn't exactly want that to happen. So, I don't know if it's a good or bad story, but I'm just telling you right now, that teacher was teaching at that school for over 20 years. She was the oldest veteran of that school. And she just disappeared, never made an appearance again, never said goodbye to anybody. It's impossible that she did not die. There's no way. She must have passed away. And the teachers, I guess they didn't want to straight up tell us that she passed away. So, I guess, Miss Pineapple, you know what? I didn't like you as a teacher. But maybe it's fair. Maybe as you aged, you got a little bit bitter and, decided to take the dark path towards being a dislikable teacher. So let's all do a little prayer for Mrs. Pineapple. Hopefully, you know, she wasn't punished for her actions. Oh, all right, here we go. Praise to the Lord as I'm gushy. All right, so Miss Pineapple, I guess thank you for, you know, enforcing that homework needs to be done prior to school. Kind of. And, yeah, there's, even if she didn't die at that exact time, she's guaranteed dead by now. That was, like, almost, you know, 6-7 years ago. Yeah. But hopefully you guys enjoyed this video. 300th video is what this is. And you can thank Windows Live Movie Maker for this, incredibly underwhelming 300th video. I'm gonna have to learn how to use something better, because honestly, Windows Live Movie Maker, it's failed me too many times in the past. It's not have a good track record. So I'm going to end it out right here. 300th video. It's crazy stuff. It also proves how lazy I am. Almost 3 years and I only have 300 videos. That's kind of bad. It's actually really, really bad. Oh my God. Yeah, so whatever, I guess. A 3-year video will be coming soon, explaining what I plan on improving. And other than that, rate, comment, subscribe. Peace out. Hope you guys enjoyed. Bye.